Here's three forgotten universal truths that will create more happiness, joy, and allow you to attract the things that you want in your life. This is Jake Ducey with JakeDucey.com. Let's dive right into these three things that we've all forgotten. Number one, your doubts aren't your own thoughts. Yeah, you heard that right. Your doubts and your fears and any limitations that come inside of your head are not even you. Who could they be then? Who they are is the collective consciousness of our world and the way that it's negatively programmed. Think about it. Those thoughts aren't even you. You've just been accustomed to think that way. You've been habitually programmed to think that way. If humanity, all of humanity, was only one person, only one thought process, what do you think would be the dominant thought process there? It would be pretty much negative. Think about it. We're conditioned to think that we aren't that good, we aren't that smart, that we aren't that special, that not that much is possible for us, that the world's coming to an end, there's all these economic problems, only a couple people can be actually successful, most people can't find their soulmates, there's no good guys out there, life is pain, life's a bitch and then you die. We're told all these silly ideas, and over time that all imprints into our subconscious mind. So there's a collective consciousness, and that's a predominantly negative and limited collective consciousness because the majority of people are not living their best lives, unfortunately. You know, they say 75% of Americans, according to Gallup polls, said they're actively disengaged from their jobs. 75% of people are not living their dream career life. Well, we're also at a very, very, very high rate of lack of confidence in the world. You know, there's a high majority of people who don't feel that they can create what they want in life. And that's because our whole culture, from advertisers to the media, to the music, to the movies, has conditioned us to think less than ourselves. So this collective consciousness is predominantly negative, and it's playing itself out into all of us as individuals. So your negative thoughts aren't you, they're the subconscious mind. In fact, psychologists say we have 65,000 thoughts in a day. 70% of them are negative and redundant. So if that's you, then the thoughts are not even you, but you believe that they're you. And what I want to invite you to consider is you can replace them at any moment. I hypnotize myself. I recorded my own success hypnosis like 6-7 years ago, and I've been using it every single day since then. It's down below jakeshypnosis.com that you can use it. But what I want to invite you to consider is that those doubts aren't you. Just remember, they're just the collective consciousness. It's our identification to them that stops us, right? The thought comes in and says, you're too old, you're too young, you're too overweight, you're too skinny, you're not good enough to ask them out, you can't make more money, how would that ever happen? This won't happen for you. You just say, wow, we have a super limited collective consciousness. Because the only reason it stops us is when we believe it's us. Oh yeah, you're right, I am not smart enough. You remember that time in seventh grade when I did bad and my teacher said I wouldn't amount to anything, and you know, and then it just goes off, right? And then we believe the thought that we're thinking. The actual limitation doesn't come from the thought itself. It comes from us believing in the thought. And I'm here to tell you your thoughts, negativity, and doubts aren't you. It's the collective consciousness. You can reprogram it with my success hypnosis down below. And remember, you gotta brainwash yourself before the world brainwashes you. Number two, challenges and stresses can actually give us the deepest meaning we've ever had in our entire life. See, what happens is we face challenges and obstacles, and then we say what? Why is this happening to me? Why is this happening to me again? I wish my life was easier. I wish I didn't have to go through this. And the ironic thing is quite often the hard work, the challenges, the sacrifice, the pain, the sense of suffering, the feeling of suffering ends up being the very thing that creates the most meaning in our lives. And Tony Robbins says, it's not the situations that you go through, but the meaning that you give to them. So one person can go through a financial challenge and they can say, okay, this is life testing me. Obviously, I need to get better. I need to learn more. I need to study more. I need to do things the right way. I need to grow as a person. And somebody else might say, why is this happening to me? and their belief system around it is that they're being punished by life. And what I'm inviting you to consider is that your challenges aren't here to kill you. They're not here to break you. They're here to transform you and reshape you into who you truly can be. The real you that you can be in this life. Like the real, great, awesome, badass version of yourself. That's the purpose of challenges. And so if you're going through something right now, I just want to invite you to consider that it might be the thing that gives you the deepest meaning in life. And then on the contrary to that, other people might say, you know, that they don't want to work hard on their dream and that they wish it was easier. And I invite you to consider just simple daily hard work is often the most meaningful thing ever if it's in alignment and moving us forward on our purpose. Number three, the fact that you're alive at all is a blessing. Think about it. We always forget this because why? Because we're living in the matrix. We have so many things to do. Our alarm goes off. Then we got to be here. Then we got to feed the kids. Then I got to get to work. Then I got to pay my bills. Then I got to remember to eat. And then I have to make myself dinner. And then I forgot to get gas. And then I forgot I need a new pair of socks. I forgot to pay my water bill. I need to pay my water bill. I'm a couple days late. I don't want to get charged a couple extra dollars, right? We're so always doing something that we forget. Like, just think about the fact that, like, literally you're alive. If you believe in the idea that we all are spiritual beings in a physical body, that you have a soul, and you believe in an infinite world, like that there's infinite souls out there, and there's only 7 billion people in this physical body, that you're blessed enough to be a soul in a physical body in this beautiful life. You're blessed to be a spiritual being who's been given the opportunity to be alive in this physical incarnation, to experience the joys, the highs, the lows, the struggles, the pain, the meaning, the love of life. And that's beautiful. You get to see the colors. You get to hear things. You get to hug people, feel emotions. You get to pay for things and learn about money and learn about yourself and experience love and grow through the pain of relationships and through the stresses and highs and lows of life. You get to do this. You get to smile. You get to laugh. You get to do all of that stuff. Isn't that amazing that you're a human being and you get to do that? Please don't forget that. Everybody forgets that. That's the big secret of life, is that we forget that life is a beautiful thing. Albert Einstein, in fact, said there's two ways to look at the world. The first way is to look at the world like nothing is a miracle. And the second way is to look at life like every single thing is a miracle. Think about it. It's all a miracle. You turn the switch and the lights come on. Somebody else figured it out. I didn't have to figure out electricity. You didn't have to figure out electricity. We get to use the benefits of it. I didn't have to figure out the combustion engine, but I get to drive a car now. I didn't have to figure out hybrids and electric vehicles, but we get to appreciate the environmental benefits of things like that. I didn't have to ship all the food across the world, and I didn't have to grow the food. I didn't have to figure out how to purify water, but I get to experience all the benefits of that, and you do too. So this is a community of people that are devoted to positivity and optimism. And so thank you for being a part of the community to spread that. This is Jake Doocy with JakeDoocy.com talking about three forgotten truths that will make your life a zillion, zillion, zillion times better. Download my free success hypnosis down below. It's JakesHypnosis.com. Reprogram your subconscious mind for success and abundance. Press the subscribe button in the corner over there. I'm over in Maui, Hawaii. Let me know where in the world that you are coming from. Love to know. Thank you for being a part of the community, and see you on the next video.